Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful, and triumphant. Oh, come, let us adore him. This is our Sunday leading into Christmas week, and we are so blessed and thankful to have you on today. Thank you for joining us here at New Heart on this morning. Are you glad to be in the number? Are you excited to be in the number? Come on and put those hands together this morning. We're going into almost the last week of the year, and we are so excited that God has allowed us to be present and to be alive on this Sunday. As we open up this morning, we simply want to tell you to adore the name of Jesus Christ, for he is our Lord and Savior, and he deserves the highest praise. Is that right? Bless you, Lord. Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, adore him, Christ our Lord. Oh, sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation. Oh, sing all ye citizens of heaven above. To God, glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ our Lord. Help us sing. Worthy to be praised. This morning, Sister Rashonda Drinkins will bring our prayer. We will have our Old Testament by Sister Kiana Bell and our New Testament by our Deacon Green. Amen.
Everyone can bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father God, we come before you this morning, God, to say thank you, God. We thank you for another morning's rising, God, and we thank you, Lord, for just keeping us. We thank you for life, health, and strength on today, God. And Lord, we just come before you and ask that you would cleanse us and forgive us of all of our sins, dear Heavenly Father God. Sins known and unknown, dear God, please forgive us, dear Heavenly Father. Lord, as we enter into this Christmas season, God, we just simply want to say we love you, God. Lord, we praise your name, God. We worship you and we honor you, dear Heavenly Father God. We thank you, Lord, for coming to this world to save us for our sins, dear God. We pray, God, that for your continued protection, God, even during these times, dear God. We have almost made it through the year, God, and you have kept your hand of protection upon us, God. For that, we say thank you. Lord, we pray right now just to keep the first family, dear God. Lord, keep them lifted, dear Heavenly Father, God. We pray that that vision, God, you just bring it forth in the name of Jesus, God. 2021 will be our year, dear Heavenly Father, God. For you are God that you cannot lie, dear Heavenly Father, God. So we know that everything that you have promised, dear God, will come to pass, Lord. Lord, we pray right now that you would bring forth a great word on today that would penetrate the hearts of your people, dear God. Lord, we pray right now that we would just, your anointing would fill this place, dear Lord. We pray, God, that you just send a special blessing, dear God, to everyone, dear Heavenly Father God, that will hear this message. We love you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
And 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. And the word of the Lord is already blessed.
Amen. Good morning, church. Good morning. I'll be reading Matthew's 11 through 5. And it says, now it came to pass, when Jesus finished commanding his 12 disciples, that he departed from there to teach and preach in their cities. And when John had heard in prison about the works of Christ, he sent two of his disciples and said to him, Are you the coming one? Or do we look for another? Jesus answered and said to them, go and tell John the things which you hear and see. The blind receive their sight, and the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear, and the dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. The word has already been blessed. Amen.
Man, we thank the Lord for his word. We know that there's no one like the Lord, no one like him. There's none like Jesus. I don't know about you, but I feel like blessing the Lord a little bit this morning. So if you're with us, go ahead and get out of your seat at home. If you're in the kitchen cooking, keep cooking and just move with us. Clap your hands, shake your head, wave your hand, whatever you're doing. If you're on the couch, rock back and forth. Just enjoy us this morning. Is that right? Come on, y'all. There's none like the Lord, no one like him. And it goes like this. There is no one like him, no one. No one like him, no one, no one. No one like the Lord. There is no one like the Lord. No one. No one like him. Sing that again. There's no one like the Lord. Oh, no, no. We say no. Hey, no one. Come on, let's let them know. You call my name from guilt and shame. Come on. You took my brokenness and you filled it with your mercy and your grace. And now I know that I am free. Thank you, Jesus. There is no one like the Lord. Oh, yes. There is no. Say no one, no one. Hey, let's tell them again. Say you called my name. You took it from guilt and shame. And you took the brokenness inside of me. And you filled it with your mercy and your grace. And now I thank you, Jesus, that I am. Say, there is no one like the Lord. No one like the Lord. No one like the Lord. Come on, put those hands together. We just want to tell you this. There's none like Jesus. No one else like him on this earth or in the heavens. He can heal you, he can save you, and he can free you. Come on, y'all. There's none like Jesus. Come on, say no one. There's none like Jesus. We bless you, Lord. Say there's no one like him. There's none like Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. There's none like Jesus. Yeah, no one else. Say there's none. There's no one like the Lord, and we sing glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth, goodwill to you. The blessings of the Lord be upon you and your family. All right, y'all. This is one of my favorite, a song that Elder Dukes wrote, and it's a little tradition of ours to sing, so we're gonna sing it for you on this morning. Here we go. Say glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
Oh, glory to God in the highest. That's all it says. Oh, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Oh, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Y'all got it? Let's sing it again. Oh, glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
We say glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God.
Are y'all praising him this morning? Oh, peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Yeah, Lord.
Oh, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Come on. Say hallelujah. Come on, y'all. Say, Master. We call you Savior. He's our Redeemer. Redeemer. He's a gift to us. A gift to us. God. Say, Master. You are my Savior. You are my Redeemer. He is a gift to us. Say, oh. Say glory to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Come on, we're going to take it back one more time. Put those hands together. We got to let him know that he's the master of our life. He's the savior of our souls. He's the redeemer of this world. And he's a gift from God. Say, Master. You are my Savior. Jesus, my Redeemer. He's a gift to us, yes. Oh, Master. You are my Savior.
Sending your son Jesus that we might have a right to the tree of life. Thank you for saving us and sanctifying us and filling us with your precious Holy Ghost. Thank you for giving us a mind to run on and see what the end's going to be. Now, Lord, we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory today for all that you've done. For sacrificing your son to come that we might be able to love, to appreciate all that you do for us. Thank you. For if it had not been for you, Lord, on our side, we would be like a ship without a sail. But thank you for coming in and changing us and making us better. Now bless the day, let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And it is so, and so it is, in Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. Come on, give the Lord hand of praise. God is good all the time or sometimes. That sound good. Do keep playing that. I hope that I can get there. Luke 2 and 12, and then we're going to move on. God bless you. We thank God for you that are watching on Facebook and YouTube. Please share right now. Please share. Please have a watch party right now for me. Amen. This is the time of the year. We're near the end of the year, but near the time of the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. What a wonderful time to celebrate and to be a part of this great occasion. Amen. We love it because he came that we might be better. I don't know about you. I'm better now. Since I found him, Brother Ramos, I'm better now. Amen. How many know you remember when you weren't better? But I'm better now because he lived. I can face tomorrow. Amen. Just this one scripture, Luke 2 and 12. Keep that going, Dukes. That's good. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Can I read that one more time? Luke 2 and 12. And this shall be a sign unto you, And ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. If you allow me to just share a word this morning, not a long word, but I want to preach from this subject, the baby that changed the world. Amen. I want to preach from this subject, the baby that changed the world. Look at your neighbor and say, the baby that changed the world. Dear Jesus, I love you. You're a friend of mine. You supply my every need. My I'm aware you are the source from which all blessings flow, and with this thought in mind, just where to go. Can I sing that one more time? Dear Jesus, I love you. Is this your testimony? Come on, comment in that comment section. You're a friend of mine. You supply my every need. I'm aware you are the source from which all blessings flow, and with the thought in mind, I know just where. I know just where. I know just where to go. How many of you know just where to go? Amen. God bless you. Now, before I go any further, I want the first lady to come. Today is her birthday. Amen. I want to share with the world this morning. I normally keep her to myself. Amen. But come on, first lady. Amen. Birthday day. And we're going to sing happy birthday to her. Come on now. Singers, get ready. I'm not gonna tell you how young she is. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. It's your birthday on this day. Oh, come on. Happy birthday. Come on now. Yeah. Happy birthday. It's your birthday on this day. Come on, help her now. Come on, say words first, lady.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I just thank and praise God for another day. If it wasn't my birthday, I was still thanking. Amen. I just thank him for all the marvelous things that he has done for me over the years. He's done more than I could ever imagine. And I just say thank him today for that. I thank him for the wonderful family that he has given me. I also thank him for, the wonderful church family, and just for people that are in my life in general. I just thank and praise him because he's been better to me than I could ever be to myself. And I thank him for that, because sometimes we beat ourselves up, we abuse ourselves in so many ways. And I just thank him for his grace and his mercy on today, for it was his grace and his mercy that brought me thus far. So I just ask that you all continue to pray for me as I continue to live the life that he has put before me. And to each and every one of you, if I don't see you before, have a merry, merry Christmas. And please do not forget the reason for the season. Amen. God bless you.
Wasn't that wonderful? Amen. Almost cut me a slice right. It was up here, but praise God. I thank God for God's just still having her here. Do y'all hear me? Amen. God bless you. We love you. Yeah. Amen. I told them when my birthday comes, I'm going to let the whole church have a day, each family. So y'all can go ahead and plan. Each family has a day. Amen. See that? Have not because you. All right. And this shall be a sign unto you. I'm not going to be long. Ye shall, if you say amen soon, I can do it in 10 minutes. Amen. If you don't say anything, I can do it in 2 hours. Amen. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. God bless all of you that are watching today. I hope that this week is not just about clothes. Dukes is not just about the jewelry. It's okay to get those things, but we must understand if we never have any of that, as long as you got Jesus. Amen. That's the key. You don't want to go through this world and never know who he is. And because he came that we might have the right to the tree of life. He came. He was brought here for our sins. And I thank God for what John 3:16 said. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him, what? Should not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. So I thank God for him. And we see that the sign that the Messiah, the God, had indeed come to save his people. And this was something that he would be the baby that the shepherds would find wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger. The sign that the Messiah, God had indeed come to save his people, would be this baby that they talked about. Now watch this. Wouldn't this be unusual place for a baby to lie, especially being the divine Messiah. Are y'all talking with me right now? Huh? Amen. There's a Greek word, spargano, meaning to swathe or to wrap. The Jews also wrapped their dead in stripes of cloth as they did their infants. Amen. This birth was a reminder of the death that would come to follow Jesus. One Bible teacher once said, the great mystery of the manger is that God could translate deity into humanity. Y'all don't hear me. Without discarding the deity or distorting the humanity. There are those that try to bring doubt about the fact that Jesus was born of a virgin. They believe that this is impossible. We're now hearing people giving their public opinion about what they think of Christmas season. They are saying that we should not include Christ in this Christmas season. They are letting their opinions be known by saying that Christ and carols and the story of Christ is offensive. And you know, as some of us that lock in the so much stuff we hear, and we start just doing whatever we hear. But when I think about where he brought me from, anybody know what I'm talking about? When I think about how I used to be and where I am now, is there anybody can talk to me? I know most of you were born with a silver spoon or a gold spoon in your mouth and a crown and a robe, amen, and rings all over your finger. Amen. I wasn't born like that. Amen. But I thank God that I found a Savior. Amen. And the song says, and he is what? Sweet, I know. Amen. So we look at this a few moments. One who was born over 2,000 years ago. If we take a look at this, this birth changed the world. Now watch this. Not only did it change the world, I can quit right here. It changed you and me. Anybody know what I'm talking about? If you have not changed since you found Jesus, you need to keep calling him until he changes you. Amen. Some folk, you question the change by what they do and by how they act. Is there anybody with me? Amen. Nobody should be able to question if you know him or not. They should see it. You should never, ever happen to have to open your mouth about, I got Jesus. They ought to be able to see Jesus. I wish I had my voice this morning. Somebody shout glory. But what is a baby? A baby is a very young child, especially one newly and recently born. We think about G3, the new baby of the family. He's already laughing. They've already trained him, Ashton and Michael and MJ and Micah, and he's already on a roll. Amen, amen. But he brings the joy. They all brought a different sense of joy when they were born. Now, some of you that have children, do you remember when you had your first child? The change that came in your life, things that you wouldn't do. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. Most of the time you would sleep through the alarm, but now with a baby yelling and a baby, don't tell me about the change. Amen. Now you're up changing diapers and you're sitting up in the midnight hour normally when you were asleep. Watch this. The life you used to have, you don't have no more. Thank God I ain't got no more babies. Come on, say praise the Lord. Amen. Can't go back there. Can't do that. I thank God for the grandchildren because they can come over. You can love them. You can play with them. And then you can send them home. Come on, say praise the Lord. And that's the good thing. Watch this. There's a great discussion. I'm almost there, Dukes. About this child that we are told that was born around this time of the year. Watch this. The Muslims, for example, believe that Jesus was born of a virgin just like Christians do. But they see him as a great prophet and call him Issa, Eben, Miriam. Jesus, the son of Mary. A great man, but nothing more, hear this, than a prophet. Y'all ain't with me. The Jewish people now see Jesus as a great teacher and a political performer, but nothing more. Y'all ain't saying that to me. The Hindus have to revere Jesus as a self-realized saint who reached the highest level of God's consciousness. So the question still remains, what child is this? Who was this baby? Do I have a witness here? 700 years before the cradle rock, before the stars were shown, before the wise men gave their gifts, before the angels sung their songs, Isaiah dipped into the prophetic pen and inspired and wrote what has become the centerpiece and the cornerstone of Christmas prophecy. There was no room in his own hometown and with his own people. Isn't that something to be able to be born into a family that don't care nothing about you? Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Isn't that something to be born into a world you came to save souls and they don't care anything about you? And no room for the king. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Isaiah tells us, while under the leadership of the Holy Ghost, that no one should misunderstand you from this point on. Who is this child? Who is this child? There's something special about this child. There's something special about his nature. Do I have a witness here? For us, unto us a child is born, and to us a son is given. Do I have a witness here? This child was gentle. Isaiah says, for unto us a child is born. This speaks of his humanity. Jesus was born the Son of Man. Jesus was born of an earthly mother. Put on human flesh. Lived 33 years on earth as a human being. But watch this. Jesus walked like a man. Jesus talked like a man. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Jesus thought like a man. Jesus had feelings like a man. Jesus ate like a man. Jesus had emotions like a man. Jesus hurt like a man. Jesus was tempted like a man. Jesus hungered like a man. Jesus thirsted like a man. Jesus suffered like a man. Jesus died like a man. Jesus was buried like a man. When Jesus was born in the flesh, it revealed his greatness. You see, when he put on the human flesh, he knew from that moment on what you and I feel. When we hurt, he hurt. When we go through, he goes through. My brothers and sisters, every feeling that you could ever have, Jesus had the same feeling. Can I get a witness here? In Hebrews 4:15, it says, for we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Jesus could reach out and touch a child because he was a child. Jesus could reach out and touch the poor. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Jesus could reach out and help those who felt lonely because because sometimes he felt lonely. Who is this child? Can I get a witness here? Somebody said he's the baby that changed the world. Can I get a witness here? This child was born on Christmas. He was gentle. I want to know this morning, how many gentle Christians do we have? How many submissive Christians do we have? Can I get a witness here? As a child, he is the Son of Man. As a son, he is the Son of God. As a child, he helps us to understand his earthly beginnings. As a son, he helps us to understand his eternal being. As a child, this tells us that he was a baby of Bethlehem. As a son, this tells us he was the God of glory. Can I get a witness here? But I'm so glad this child that changed the world, not only did he change the world, but he changed me. Come on, say yes. Not only did he change the world, he changed my walk. He changed my talk. Can I get a witness here? And I heard somebody say, look where he brought me from. Is there anybody in here that can testify that I've been changed since Jesus has come? I've been changed. The world has changed. Can I get a witness here? People all over the world are praising him this week. Alcoholics, drug addicts, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Cocaine users are praising him all over the world because he changed their lives. Can I get a witness here? But I'm so glad, I said I'm so glad that an angel came down and spoke to Mary and said, Mary, somebody say, Mary, Mary, thou art highly favored with God. Can I get a witness here? You shall bring forth a son. It shall be the Son of the Highest. I don't think you realize sometimes who we serve, but I thank God that I serve Jesus, the lily of the valley. I serve Jesus, the bright and morning star. He is the baby that changed the world, changed my mind, changed my heart, changed my talk. Anybody hear me? Changed me. I'm so glad. I said I'm so glad that I've been changed. Tell your neighbor. Oh, come on here. Tell your neighbor. I've been changed since I've been born again. I've been changed. John 3:16 say, for God so loved the world that he gave. I want to ask a question. How many of you would give up your child for the sins of this world? Oh, y'all ain't saying that now. All you tongue speakers, all you aisle runners, all you chair leapers, how many of you would give up your child for the sins of the world? But God, I said, God saw how sinful this world was, and he gave up his only child to this world, for he sent his child into this world not to condemn it, but that the world through him might be saved. This baby changed the world. Come on, y'all ain't gonna help. There is a star born. Jesus is the star. Can I get a witness here? He is the center of my joy. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. This peace that I have, when I found him, y'all ain't gonna help me here. When I found him, I found peace. I found joy. Thank you, Lord, for coming into this world. Thank you, Lord, for coming into my life. Is there anybody that know what I'm talking about? Just witness to your neighbor and say, neighbor, when he came, he changed me. Is there anybody that can comment in the comment section and say, I know, I know I've been changed because he changed my life. He changed the world. The world might have trouble in it. The world might have problems in it. But do you imagine what it would be like if he didn't come? Can I get a witness here? Whoa! Just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm so glad that he came, and because he came, I got my joy back, and because he came, I got my peace back, and because he came, he changed. He changed everything around me. My walk, my talk. Can I get a witness here? Just tell somebody. Just tell somebody. He's the God of eternity, the all-sufficient one, Jehovah ruler. He's the independent one, ever-loving one. I just want to know this morning, because he came, what is he is to you? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, what is he? What is he to you? Is he your peace? Is he your joy? Is he your happiness? I thank God that he came, and because he lives, because he was born, I was born again. Look at your neighbor and say, because he was born, I was born again. Thank you, Lord, for born. Thank you, Lord, for coming. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, for sending your son. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm so glad that he changed the world. Yeah! Said that this child has a name. We know him as Jesus, our Lord, our Master, our Savior. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lion of the tribe of Judah. He's the Rose of Sharon, the Bright and Morning Star. He's wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father. Can I get a witness here? Is there anybody here just can tell me what he is to you? Just look at your neighbor and say, oh neighbor, he's my joy, he's my peace, he's my happiness. Yes, he's everything, everything I need, everything I want. Say yeah, he's God in his presence, in his provision, in his power, in his perception, in his promises, in his protection. I thank God that this baby came to change the world. I know we're going through a pandemic. I know food is in shortage. I know trouble is everywhere. Because he came, we can stand on God's word, stand on his promises. Though they slay us, yet will we trust him. Just stand on God's word. Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you, but I'll be with you always, even till the end of the world. Isn't anybody here know what I'm talking about? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, that baby boy changed the world. And I'm so glad, not only did he change it, but he claimed it. I'm King of Kings, I'm Lord of Lords. Not only did he change it, watch this. He came to take away every hurt. Because some of you, you still wear your hurt. But you haven't. Cast all your cares upon the baby. We do know babies grow up. He grew up just like us, human, going through suffering, but he understood his purpose. Do you understand your purpose? Why do you do what you do? Why do you claim a man you've never seen? Why do you serve him? You know why? Through the scriptures, God has taught us about who he is. And because we've allowed the scriptures to become a part of our life, it gives us a connection with the one that we read about. When we accepted him in our lives, we became one with him. Watch it. You knew nobody else could do it. Where were you 5 years ago, spiritually? Not 10, 20, Brother Ramos. We don't want to go that far. Might not get back. Where were you 5 years ago, spiritually? Have you, since this baby has come into the world, become better? Are you better now than you were 5 years ago? Are you better now? Have you grown? because of this baby? Can you love better now? Can you forgive better now? That was a time we couldn't. Oh, y'all don't want to tell the truth. Facebook, that was a time you couldn't love like you love now. But because this baby came, he changed your heart. Took away that stony heart. Gave you a heart of flesh, a heart to love. Y'all don't hear me. Those that mistreated you, he allowed you to see them and love them in spite of all that they've done. That's what happened. That was the change from the baby. Because if the baby hadn't come, you would have never changed. This world would really be in trouble. But he was sent here for us. Take advantage of your baby brother. We're heirs and joint heirs with him. He's our Savior, our brother. Huh? Do you love him? How much do you love him? He said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments and have love one to another. See, if you love him, you can't love like the world. Oh, my God. I say, if you love him, you can't love like the world. See, the world's a little different. They won't love you. They'll tell you they love you and do something else. But if you love him, you love him. And you follow him. And you live. You allow him to live in you. And he'll show up and show out for you, won't he? Come on, let us pray. Stand to your feet. Maybe somebody there after hearing this message today, the baby that came to change the world. Not only did this baby change the world, but it changed you. I thought about that the other day. Had not Jesus come, you think about what we're going through now, Brother Ramos? Brother Jairus, you think about what we're going through now? You imagine if Jesus hadn't come? But I thank God, even in the midst of trouble, he said, I'll be there, I'll never what? Leave you, nor what? Forsake you. He said, I'll be with you what? Always. Even till the end of the world. Father God, we thank you. For your power, we thank you for your joy, your love. Now, there's someone that heard this message today that haven't been changed and they're ready for a change. I want you to stand right where you are in your living room and throw up your hands and say, Lord, change me. Change my heart, change my mind. Lord, I believe that you came to save a wretch like me. I believe you came to forgive me of all my sins. And Lord, forgive me of all my sins. Whatever I've done, my transgressions, everything that I've done against the will of God. Lord, forgive me. Come into my life. Change me. Make me whole again. Wash me in your blood. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. And God, I thank you. And I believe it. Hide your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. And we thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you for saving that woman, that man right now that's standing there in their living room. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for that soul that decided to come to you because you came into this world as a baby and changed the world. For me, you changed this world for me, and I thank you. Now, God, those that have stood and confessed their sins unto you, we receive them as you did. we touch and agree. You said anything that we ask in your name shall be done. And it is so, and so it is in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. You that accept the Christ in your life, call us here at the church at 386-238-0050 and let us know who you are. If you want to put it in the comment, that's fine. And if not, call us at the church so we'll know who you are. We want to partner with you in the spirit and be there to help lead and guide you. We'll put you in direct with one of our ministers, evangelists, to have someone to walk with you through this walk in the name of Jesus. Now, if there's somebody that don't have a church home, you love to be a part of New Heart Ministries, we love to have you. It doesn't matter where you are in the world, we can connect with you. Amen. And we would love to have you. Call us here at that number, 386-238-0050. Amen. And God bless you. We love you. We're getting ready to give at this time. God bless you. You may take your seat. We thank God for all of you this morning, those that have asked for special prayer, Sister Janice Davis and Sister Gulk. Amen. We're praying for them that God will be with them and touch their bodies, and all the others that are sick and shut in and have been calling and asking for prayer. We're getting ready to give. Amen. You that are watching, amen. New Heart members, we know what we do. Amen. And you keep doing what you're doing, giving your offering, paying your tithe. Amen. Up on the screen, there are ways for you to give. Amen. You may not be a member, a physical member, or just an internet member, a Facebook member with us. We pray that you will give today, that you will plant a seed into our ministry today. Amen. God bless you. We pray that God will give you the things that you desire. But how many of you understand sometimes we have to make a sacrifice to give and show God how much we appreciate what he does. We don't tell you what to give here. Our members have a certain thing that they do, and they are tithers. We thank God for our givers and members that give and tithe. And maybe somebody you know about tithing and giving, and you haven't been doing it, and God just touched your heart. Amen. You give and tithe. You could go right now online with the PayPal, the Cash App that's on the screen. Amen. And God will bless you for your giving. God blesses a cheerful giver. Amen. You that are tithers. He said he would open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you wouldn't have room enough to receive. And the Bible talks about it in Malachi 3:8. Says, will a man rob God? Wherein have we robbed thee? In what? Tithe and offering. He said, ye are cursed with a curse. We don't need no curses. Amen. Amen. Ain't a dollar that much that I got to keep. Amen. That would cause me to be cursed by God. And God will bless you for planting your seeds when you give from the depths of your heart. God bless you. We love you. Just look on the screen there. Amen. And you can give through PayPal, Cash App, and whatever else they may have there. God bless you. We love you. And you that don't use the internet, members of our church, amen. Some of our younger elderly ones, you can come by the church. Amen. Someone will be here to greet you, and you can bring your offering at this time. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Amen. And from the First Lady and I just want to say something special. Come on, First Lady. You're going to say it with me today. Amen. Amen. My t-shirts are on the way. Amen. Just get ready. All I like to say to you is what?
Remember, only what you do for Christ will last.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Till we meet again. He taught me how to watch, fight and pray, my Lord, good God. We'll rejoice in, yeah, every day. Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day. When Jesus was. Oh, when he was. Oh, when he was. He washed my sins away. Oh, happy day. One more time, dudes. Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day. When Jesus was. Oh, when he was. Oh, when he was. He washed my sins away. Oh, just a happy day. He taught me how to watch, fight and pray, my Lord, good God. Fight and pray, and we'll rejoice, and we'll rejoice. Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
It's gonna be a happy day. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Hold on a little while longer. Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
When Jesus was.
When Jesus was.
Oh, when he was.
When Jesus was.
Oh, when he was.
When Jesus was.
Wash my sins away.
Oh, happy day. Oh,
Tell him,